Hello children, welcome back to the e-learning classes. In the previous lesson, we have learned about countable and uncountable nouns. Yes, so today we will start with our next lesson, that is singular and plural nouns. Children, countable nouns can be one or many. It refers to one or more than one person, animal, place or thing. Children, when we are speaking about one thing, we use singular form of the noun, whereas when we are speaking about many things, we use the plural form of the nouns. Okay, so let us see the definition and examples of singular and plural noun. Singular noun, a noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. I repeat, a noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. Children, here are some examples to understand it. A girl, an elephant, a building, and a computer. Children, these all examples refer to one noun. So, they are all singular nouns. Okay, now let's move with plural nouns. Plural noun, a noun that names more than one person, animal, place or thing is called a plural noun. I repeat, a noun that names more than one person, animal, place or thing is called a plural noun. For examples, girls, elephants, buildings and computers. These all examples refer to more than one noun. So, they all are plural noun. Okay, I hope you all are now clear with singular and plural noun. Isn't it? Yes. Children, when we have to change the singular noun to plural noun, we need to follow certain rules. So, let's learn the rules of it. The plural of most words is made by adding the letter S to the word. For examples, girl, girls. Simply by adding S, we can change the noun into plural form. Apple, apples. Bag, bags. Door, doors. Dog, dogs. Street, streets. Children, here simply by adding S, we have changed the singular noun to plural noun. Okay. Children, when the noun that end with S, double S, CH, SH, O or X, we add ES to the singular forms to make it plural. For example, bus, buses, fox, foxes, branch, branches, wish, wishes, tomato, tomatoes, class, classes. Here, the given words ends with S, X, CH, SH, O and double S. So, we have added ES to make it plural. Okay. Children, certain nouns that end with F or FE changes to VES. For examples, calf, calves, wife, wives, wolf, wolves, knife, knives. Here, the given words end with F or FE. So, we just have to remove F or FE from the end of the word and instead of that, we have to write VES at the end of the word to make it plural. Okay, children? Now, let us learn how to form the singular noun to plural noun with words ending with Y. Children, the plural of words ending with Y depends upon the letter before the Y. Let us understand it with some examples. First one, boy, boys. Key, keys. Here, in the given words, that is boy and key, before Y, letter O and E are there. Yes, and both O and E are vowels. So, when there are vowels, that is A, E, I, O, U, before Y in the word, we simply add S and make it plural as in boys, boys and key, keys. Okay, children. Now, have a look at these words. Baby, babies. Candy, candies. Duty, duties. Pony, ponies. Country, countries. Here, in the given words, that is baby, candy, duty, pony and country, before Y, letter B, D, T, N, R are there. Yes, and these all letters are consonants. So, when there are consonants before Y in the words, we have to remove Y from the word and instead of it, we have to add IES as in the above examples. Okay. Children, some words do not follow any of the above rules. For examples, foot, feet, goose, geese, ox, oxen, child, children, mouse, mice, tooth, teeth, man, man, woman, woman. In the given words, we don't add S, ES, IES or VES to make it plural. Instead, the spelling of the word changes when we have to make it plural. Okay. Children, however, there are certain nouns which do not change their spellings in their plural forms. For example, fish, deer, sheep, furniture. These given words remain the same for singular as well as plural nouns. Okay, children. With this, I hope you all are clear with the rules of changing singular words to plural words. So, we can now start with our first exercise of this lesson, which is there on page number 27 of your textbook. Page number 27, exercise 1. Filling the blanks with the correct plural form of the nouns given in the bracket. Children, you have to just write the plural form of the word which is already there in the bracket and one sentence is done for you. So, let us read that first. You must put away your toys after playing with them. See, here in the bracket toy is given. So, the plural of toy is toys. Okay. So, like that we have to write the plural form of the words which are there in the bracket. See the next one. The dash are swimming in the tank. In the bracket, fish is there. Yes. So, the plural form of fish will be fish only. It does not change. Whether it is singular, whether it is plural, fish ka plural is fish only. Okay. See the third one. Mother could not find her dash. Now here in the bracket, glass is given. Okay, so the plural of glass is glasses. S double S is there. So with double S, we have to add ES. Okay, so mother could not find her glasses. Next one. The church dash are ringing. So bell ka plural is bells. Only you have to add S. Okay. The church bells are ringing. Next sentence. The dash are sweet. So in the bracket mango is given. O is there at the end. So we are going to add ES to make it plural. So it will become mangoes. The mangoes are sweet. Last one. Adam has no dash. Now here in the bracket enemy is given. Okay. At the end Y is there. But before Y what is there? M. M is a consonant. So what did I said? Whenever there is a consonant before Y, we'll remove Y when we are going to add IES. So it will become ENEMIES. Enemies. Adam has no enemies. Understood? Okay. So let us start with exercise number 2. Change the underlined singular nouns to their plural forms and rewrite the following sentence. Okay. Your sentence is given. In the sentence, underlined word is given and that is in the singular form. We have to change this into plural and we have to write the full sentence again. So first one is done. The man is eating a mango. Here word underline is mango. So the man is eating mangoes. Okay. So let us see the second one. The child is flying a kite. Here the word which is underlined is kite. Kite is singular. So we have to change it into plural. So we will write the sentence first. The child is flying kites. Now children, when we write kites, kites are plural form, yes. So we don't have to add the article a or n over here. See children, here the child is flying a kite. Here a is the article used. Why? Because kite is in the singular form. Yes. So when there is when the noun is in the singular form, we use article a or n. But when the noun is in the plural form, we don't use article, that is a or n. So when we write kites in the plural form, we have to remove a. Understood? Now see the next one. I broke a dish today. Now here dish we have to change it into plural. SH is there. Yes. So with SH what we will add? ES to the noun to make it plural. So we will write I broke. Here a is there but we are changing dish into plural form. So we will remove a from the sentence. I broke dishes today. Okay. Now see the next sentence. They are moving the furniture from their house. Now here furniture is the noun. But as I told you in the explanation that some words don't change. When we have to change it into plural form, it becomes the same. So furniture will remain the same. Okay, it does not change. So we have to write the same sentence as it is. They are moving the furniture from their house. Next sentence. See, today I saw a colorful fish in the aquarium. Here fish is underlined. We have to change fish in the plural form. So the plural form of fish is fish only. We don't have to change it. Okay, we don't add anything when we make the plural of fish. Singular is also fish and plural is also fish. So the sentence will remain same. Today I saw a colorful fish in the aquarium. Okay. Now see the next sentence. The ox is running in the field. Now here field we have to change it into plural form. So we'll write the ox is running in the fields. We have to add s to make it plural. Okay. See the next sentence. She twisted her foot while dancing. Now here in some words, as I told you, we have to change the spelling of it to make it plural. So we'll change the spelling over here. She twisted her, instead of foot we will change it into feet, F-E-E-T, feet, while dancing. At the end put a full stop. She twisted her feet while dancing. Okay. See the last one. I have a talking doll. Now here we have to change doll into plural. So we will write I have. So we'll remove A. Yes, A we use for singular noun, but here we are changing dolls, a doll into doll. So we are making into plural. So we will just write I have talking dolls. Understood? Now let us see exercise number 3. Write the plural forms of the following nouns. Here also you have to write the plural of the following nouns which is given in the sentence. Okay. Make sentences with each of them. One has been done for you. Here children, noun is given, singular noun is given. You have to change it into plural and then you will have to make a sentence by yourself. Okay. So here I will discuss the plural form of all the noun and sentences you will form by yourself. Okay. Try to form the sentences by your own. Okay. Use the word plural words and then you form the sentences. So let us discuss the plural form of all the words. Bench, it will become benches. Ferry, it will become ferries. As before, Y, R is there. R is the consonant. So we will remove Y and we will add IES. Okay. So now for benches, you write a sentence over here by yourself. Okay. Make a sentence out of benches. For ferries also make a sentence and you write it by yourself. Nail, it will become nails. Glass, it becomes glasses. And story, it becomes stories. Okay, so now your homework is to make sentences and write it down in the textbook only. With this we have completed our 3 exercises of lesson number 5 also, and we have come to an end of this lesson. Thank you.